Hi, I'm Tim Green, and today I'm going to show you how to add a new wick and coil to the Clockworks RDA, that's the Repairable Dripping Atomiser, which is available from UKVapers. Specifically, this is going to be aimed at people who are using some of the fiberglass wick obtained either with the RDA or most likely the group buy of Repairable Atomiser wick, which was a group buy that that I put together on UKVapers. So let's have a quick look at what you're going to need and show you what to do. Right. Well, to repair the or change the coil and wick arrangement in the RDA, you're going to need the following: the RDA itself, which is a lovely little unit. Your mod, of course. I'm going to use a Provari so that you can see the voltage and the resistance of the coil once we've made it. Some resistance wire. This is 38 SWG nickel chrome or nichrome wire, which is 0.15. A precision Phillips screwdriver, a semi-straightened paper clip, and that's used for holding the wick and so you can actually make the coil around it. Some scissors, some tweezers if you need them, a sharp knife if you need it, obviously a drip tip, and some juice. Now, first thing you have to do is to take the aluminium section off the top of the RDA. There's a few ways you can do that. You can put in a sharp knife at the bottom and lever it up. Some people might be able to actually just wiggle it with their fingers. I can't. By far, probably the easiest method is to put it on your mod and wiggle it there. It takes a little bit of effort, but as you see, it starts coming off quite easily. A bit more wiggling, and away it comes. And there we are. I'll take this off. What we have there is the dripping atomizer. Basically, you have your positive, which is your centre pin, and your negative, and these are where that you tie in the ends of the wire. And you'll need the precision screwdriver, because if this has arrived and it's been pre-wicked and you're changing the wick, then you'll need to unscrew both these just a little bit, and then you can pull out the whole wick and wire arrangement and leave yourself with that. Now, what we're going to do is take our wick. Now, this is the 1mm diameter wick that was in the group buy. You may not have this wick. You may have opted to buy this wick, which is the 3mm diameter wick. The process and the principles are exactly the same. I'll stick with the 1mm, but you just have to do exactly the same with 3mm to achieve the desired result. First things first is I'm going to need to cut off a small length of the wick so that I can attach the coil. So we'll work out how much wick we need. And I just put it down, roughly measure out where it's going to stretch to, and that's how much wick I'm going to need to cut off. Helps if the scissors are really sharp. And there's the wick. And as you see, in a length like this, it starts wanting to unfurl, and that's fine, that's what you want it to do. But you just pull those apart, Now for this, I'm going to use two pieces. Okay. Some people might prefer to use one. I prefer to use two. But because there are four pieces in there, those two I can use to make a coil the next time I need to make a repair. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut some nichrome wire. Now this wire being 0.15, this has a resistance of 60 ohms per meter. So that's 0.6 ohms for every centimeter. So therefore, 1.5 centimeters of wire is going to give you 1.8 ohm coil. We need a little extra wire to go in the terminals. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure just with a little rule here. It doesn't have to be major precise. You can, if you wish to, put a multimeter on it and work it out exactly. I'm never that bothered because most of my mods are variable voltage. So that's 3 centimeters to there, and then a little bit extra to allow us our legs for attaching to the terminal posts. So I'll cut off there and put the rest of the wire away. Now you probably won't have a reel of wire like this. I just bought a stack of it. This wire was obtained from wires.co.uk. The reel has 840 meters of wire on it, and that was, I think, about £15. It's not very much money. It's a lot if you don't have it, but that amount of wire will probably last me a lifetime. And there's your piece of wire. So my wire, my wick, and now my paperclip. And what I'm going to do, I'll lie the wick down onto the paperclip. Now, unlike the RDA, the RDA works better with the atomizer coil right at the end of the wick. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hold the wire underneath my thumb. This is a slightly fiddly bit. Underneath my thumb, and then I'm just going to start wrapping it round. I won't pull the wire tight, but I will just pull on it enough so that it tugs the fiberglass wick down. I found that if you pull it too tight, once the wire gets too hot, it's a bit like a cheese wire effect, and it ends up cutting right through the wick. So some people prefer to actually have one end of the wire still attached to something. I generally don't do that. I just prefer it like this. And now you see I've got, how many turns have I got there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Got 4 turns of wire around there and 2 legs. Now I'm going to straighten the legs up just a little bit, and that's just to make life a little easier when it comes time to pushing those into the terminal. You're still going to have a little bit of wick sticking out the end. In fact, I'm going to just slide the coil down a little bit, make sure there's a little more. Don't want the wick coming out. Now, some people prefer to use a larger length of wick and double it over, so there's a loop there. That's fine too, I just prefer it with a cut end. And once I have this like that, I'm just going to line it up with the terminal posts here. Just adjust this a little bit so there's a bit more of a distance. One in, that's two in, there, like that. And I hold it in place with my thumb, and then screw down the terminal posts until it pinches the wire and it's down. You don't want to screw this down too hard, because if you do that, it will tug hard on the wire. You run the risk of it snapping the wire, and then you have to start all over again. Okay, so now I've got the wire in there. I'm just going to trim the ends off so that there's no chance of it making any shorts. And that's that done. Still with my thumb on the wire, I'm pressing down a little bit. I then extract the paperclip, leaving the wick and wire attached there. And then all we're going to do is we're going to just gently, loosely wrap that round. In fact, sometimes I just find it easier to just take the top and wrap it like this around and just make sure that you've got the ends inside. That one's being a stubborn end and keeps popping back up. But you know what, that's fine. Make sure you're in. There we are. And snap. And that's in. Put it on the Provare. And I'll show you what resistance that comes down to. That's a good low resistance, and make sure that the voltage on that is actually only around 4. Could go to 4.2, but can always adjust that later. Final thing, pop a drip tip on the top, and then we need to just prime the atomizer. To do that, I'll just take this quickly off the Provare. I can do it easily within camera shot. For this I'm going to use some Halo Tribeca, which is a tobacco based, tobacco flavoured juice. Now, don't over drip into there to start with. 3, 4, 5, 6. You can always add more later. My experience with this is that it will hold a lot more. Okay, let's see how this vapes. So we have here the Clockworks Repairable Dripping Atomizer. 4 volts, 1.7 ohm coil. Let's see how she goes. I'll need a little bit more juice in there, there's a bit of burn on that. So, of course, messy pup that I am, I spill some. one thing you'll find with this is that, just like his big brother, flavour's very, very intense. And you'll find that you'll be able to knock down your nicotine content a little bit because it really comes through. This is an excellent piece of kit. So there we have it, the Repairable Dripping Atomiser with a new coil using the Wick from the Repairable Atomiser Wick group buy that took place on UKVapers. I'd just like to say a big thank you to everybody who took part. The second group buy is currently underway. I'll see you on the forum. Bye for now.